You're playing a game, it's so plain. You're playing a game, it's so plain. You're playing a game, it's so plain. You're playing a game.
Hey, what's up, guys? It's your boy Blood Assassin 69 here. Getting ready to do this review on MLB The Show 14. I'd like to start off by saying this is one of the most beautiful games I've played yet on the PS4. I haven't had really any issues other than small frame rates here and there with like batter boxes and people in the crowd, and every once in a while a little glitchiness with the hitting. Not much anything else. The PS3 version, of course, always looks the same, always has better upgrades to it, but it's just not the feel of what you have in this PS4 version. Everything is smooth, from pitching to hitting to almost everything of smoothness of picking anything you want. I'd like to start off by exhibition mode. It's always going to be the mode that everybody wants. Play quick and fast. You never have any issues. Pick your teams. You can also pick all your jerseys, your hats, and your pants, and so on. That's normal. It just gets down to the part where when we get to online exhibition, we've had a lot of issues with this game. MLB The Show has been known to have a lot of online issues, but these issues just need to be fixed fast. For one, it takes so long to even get into a game that it's ridiculous. You wait forever and sometimes get booted out. They really need to fix that issue. On another note, once you get in the game, it's really laggy. Like, when I went to choose my team and I went up and down, like, it would lag in and out. The guy next to me, he worked perfectly fine. This, I was going in and out like I would skip teams, and that needs to be fixed. Well, once we got past that, I jumped in the game with him and we started playing, and the lag for hitting is ridiculous. Like, it always says you're swinging either too early or too late. You can't even get a game going. It's horrible. And there's also no way to turn off the quick counts. I haven't figured out how to turn off a quick count yet, because it's just, there's nothing to choose from. Other than that, you have other online options, as in you have online rated, and then you have to where you can invite just a friend. That's the next issue. You can invite a friend, but you can't invite multiple friends to play 2-on-2. And the fact that you can't play 2-on-2 yet, what's the point of playing? How are you going to get a group of friends together to play? You know, like, I want to play, yes, I want to play my next door neighbor, say I'm playing them, but I'd also like to play the guy down the street and the other guy down the road on 2-on-2 mode. And you can't do that. You can only challenge one friend at a time in your challenge modes. But other than that, gameplay, as I said earlier, is really good. No problems with that. It's just online mode needs to be fixed. That is the only complaint with this game. Out of anything I have so far, that's the only complaint. Next, I want to get to franchise mode. Now, franchise mode this year, you can play with all your friends. This is one part I didn't have an issue with online at all. I could get in and out of a game, and I'm my own commissioner. I could start it. You can start with 6, all the way up to every team in the roster. You pull up your rosters, you invite as many friends as you want to be part of it, and you can make out a weekly schedule. You can have customizable rosters, and everybody can see what they have to play that day. Nothing wrong there, just normal gameplay in and out of a season. Now you have things like community challenges. You can go in and do like mini community challenges that are set weekly, daily, by other community members, of like, you can have how many home runs you can get in a game to how many strikeouts you have in a game. And you can go in there and do them. Kind of a Little Big Planet feel of creating your own stuff and feel of the game and going in and passing around the community. The next thing I want to get to is, now you have what is called Road to the Show single player mode. You had them before, but this is a little bit different. You can get in and out of it really quick with having your person created. You get full up and downs of creations of your character, from chin, nose, eyes, hat. You can wear sunglasses the whole game if you want to. You do your jersey, your colors, your wristbands, your bat colors. You can get into that. But once you really get into the game, you're starting off as a kid 18, 19 years old. You can choose your age to be older. You get into it, you can play through every single area where scouts come out and watch you, and you can play those games to make yourself look better with points, and you get more points or negative points for what you do and don't do in the game. You also have full control of the way you watch the draft. You can listen to every player get drafted, every name, and all that. You are also able to replay the showcase by returning to school, but doing this, your player will age. And I noticed that when I went back to play it, my player just kept aging. Like, it doesn't stop. It's not a freeze frame in time. They want you to actually play in real-time events. The scouts, like I was talking about, they'll be grading you on your performance and in order to determine your draft stock, which you can do really well and still draft pretty bad. I did really well, and I drafted really bad. It's pretty really bad. Anyways, it's not bad, it's not good, it's great to me, because like, where else do you get an experience that you get to just jump out of school and start playing a game and try to impress people? Basically, that's what you're doing, and then you see your person progress more and more and more. That's basically what Road to the Show is, and I enjoyed it. Now, there's my one other favorite thing, which is mini games, and I could go in and play Home Run Derby. Home Run Derby was the best online experience I had. The reason is because I could get into Home Run Derby, choose my player, you choose a stadium, or you choose your stadium, you have it to where you can go play with friends. So I could start a lobby, and I only had 5 friends at the time, so there were 6 of us in a Home Run Derby, and it didn't show us each up at bat. On everybody's screen individually, you could hit the ball at your pace and what you're doing. So your player's on your screen. You don't see anybody else's other than the color of the ball that they're hitting. Now, every time the round is over for the last hitter to hit, a person would be knocked out for whoever did the worst, and it would get down to whoever won. And I didn't have any problems connecting. Online worked great. There was never anything wrong with the whole system of what was going on. Also, there's batting practice, which you can choose. On certain parts of the batting practice, you can do individual things with how you bat, or how you steal bases, or what your count is and how you want to go with it. But batting practice also gives you points to see how good you did at the end of the round, and you can progress throughout each batting practice. So I could pick who my pitcher was and how they pitched to me. And if I would hit, like, there would be a guy on second, a guy on third, and I'd hit out in the outfield and it'd get caught for an out, I would still get a few points for hitting it out there. But say I hit a grounder and it wasn't much of a hit to first base and I get out, I get negative points because it didn't seem like I had much of an effort. You would get, for like, if you got a ball thrown to you and you miss a ball, you get extra points for that. If you got a strike, you get negative points for that. It's like a win-lose situation on how that works. On top of that, there's not much more that I'd have to say that's good nor bad about the game. The game is pretty solid. They did a real well job in the 9 months they had to make this game, and they got pushed hard to make it for PS4. I don't typically play a lot of sports games, but this is one sports game I was really, really tempted to get because I heard it was only on PS4, because of course I'm a Sony guy, and it's also a baseball game that looks incredible. Like, when I seen the way it looks with all the chin hair and the way it was like individual strands and the way the players' bodies look with the shadowing and just everything, it just blew my mind. I do have a small complaint about the little bit of the graphics. I was playing the other day and I noticed that my jersey, my helmet, my bat, my gloves, my pants, they all look good with my graphics, but they could have upped it a little bit with the facial, like the face, the cheeks, not as much as the hair, just like the cheeks and arms, the skin tone and stuff. Like, they could put texture in that, man. Sometimes it looks a little smooth, and I don't want stuff that looks like low-grade PC graphics smooth on there. I want to see full texture in my arms and legs, like everything in a game. It's not what I want to see. Is the low grade of that. Batting is probably my favorite thing on here, because whenever you hit it, it has such good timing on the batting that it's great. Other than the online issue I talked about earlier, the online issue, hopefully they'll get it fixed. It's just the batting is just that crisp on just regular playing. I played one-on-one with somebody locally, not online. Everything ran smoothly and it was perfect. Like the feel of it vibrates when you hit the ball perfectly. You can call out pitches of where they're gonna be at, and then you hit it twice as hard and just so good. You also get a sense of there's beginner mode and there's advanced mode. Beginner mode, it kind of sets you up to, if you don't know how to play the game, of course, it's going to show you where to pitch. It's going to tell you what pitch to throw to that player in the box and everything. And the hitting, they basically throw you strikes, of course. Advanced now, it will change up things. You don't have, like, on beginner, you have a one hit mode with X is hit, squares, power hit, and circles just contact hit. Advanced, it sometimes changes up to where you use the thumbstick, like in the 2K games, which those games weren't bad. The fact that they didn't keep making those games because they're licensed is pretty sad, but this game took from that and it grabbed from that pretty well. I personally am a one button guy. The stick, I don't like to slam my joysticks around on my thumbsticks on my controller too much, but I've yet to play with it too much. In all, I'd say
this game is a really great game. There's there's nothing wrong with a little bit of what we had going on. All the technical issues and everything. It's just more of a personalization of playing baseball being part of the game. And it totally completes that for me. And in my eyes, the matter of fact, I think the game just kills it, dude. It's baseball. Who doesn't love baseball? Who else is, there's nothing else to buy it on. You can't buy it on Xbox One. You can't go out and buy it on Xbox 360. They do have some low grade baseball games, but this is the show and it's only on PlayStation 4. I could see guys going out and just getting PS4s and playing the show. Like seriously, it's the Titanfall for the PS4 of sports games to me. And it's just, that's the way I feel about it. You can't complain. Well, this concludes my review. In my eyes, as you guys can tell, I give this game a good old, I'd say at 8 out of 10. Just because the online and some of the frame rate issues, I wouldn't give it a straight 10. There's no way you get a 10 out of this game. It's gonna have its flaws. It's its first year on a new system, so. That concludes my review for MLB The Show 14. I'm Blood Assassin 69 here. And thanks for you guys listening and supporting. Ignorant Gamers, shout out. Blood Assassin 69 at twitter.com. Thank you.